Now on BBC One, Blue Peter.
That was Mike Oldfield, one of Britain's most successful composers, at work in his own recording studio. Mike's made a special arrangement of a very well-known tune, all for Blue Peter, and you can find out what it is a bit later on. And now, from birds to bells. And this record, Tubular Bells, must be one of the world's most popular. Since it was released in 1973, it sold over 9 million copies. And the man who composed the music played just about every instrument, and there are dozens of them, not just bells, himself. He's Mike Oldfield, and last week I went to meet him at his house in Gloucestershire, where he has his own recording studio built inside a barn. Mike's control desk looks incredibly complicated. I wouldn't know where to start, but over the years he's learnt what every knob and fader does. He uses a special 24-track tape recorder so that he can record each instrument he plays separately and then later on mix them together. Mike offered to give his special treatment to a tune I think you'll recognise.
How is it? That's all right.
So, the next stage, presumably the first instrument. Mike would hear the tick-tock noise in his headphones while he played, which would keep his rhythm constant. When he's recording through the microphone, he has to wear headphones, otherwise the tick-tock noise would be recorded as well as the guitar. It didn't sound much like the Blue Peter signature tune, but this was just the first rhythm track.
Well, it seems to go quicker than I thought it would, so I'm only going to leave it about 1 minute 25. Okay, so I'm going to check that back, see what that was.
The quality through those speakers is amazing. Mike was happy with the sound of the rhythm guitar, so he rewound the tape recorder and went on to play the next instrument. This was a barawn, an Irish drum, and it's this instrument that gives Mike Oldfield's music its distinctive sound. But he didn't just play it once, he recorded it twice so that when it's played back, it gives it a sort of echo. He also made another noise from the barawn by hitting the metal studs on its side.
That's four sounds you've recorded now.
Right.
What's this instrument?
Acoustic bass. It's like an electric bass, except it's acoustic, it's all made of wood. See? Here we go.
Okay.
Right.
As well as acoustic guitars and drums, Mike uses a lot of electronic gadgets called synthesizers. And as he started playing one, I got my first chance of hearing together everything he'd recorded so far. He recorded the synthesizer twice on two tracks. Now he'd recorded seven different sounds.
Mike, it's coming on really well. It sounds great. When are you actually going to add the signature tune?
Well, now, but it won't sound like it. What I've done is slowed the whole tape down to half the speed, and I'm to play a synthesizer tune.
What's the difference between this synthesizer and the one you've just played?
Basically no difference, except that this has got all preset sounds. Like, I'm using a clarinet sound, but speed it up, it sounds like a recorder.
Why do you have to slow it down?
Basically because I can't play it that fast.
Fair enough. I'll let you get on with it.
But it also sounds better.
Do you always have the tune
sharper.
Last?
This isn't last.
Oh. More to come.
6, 7.
Mike's fingers are those of a typical guitarist. He uses his long nails to pluck the strings, though it can't be too easy playing the keyboard. Our signature tune sounded very strange played slowly. I was intrigued to hear what it would be like once Mike had speeded it up.
There's some echo on it. People who are pretending not to be here, and we'll provide you with bells and you've got to shake them all, all right?
The people Mike was talking about were our film crew and production team. So with the selection of instruments, they joined in this Mike Oldfield recording session. We had to record our bells twice before Mike was satisfied.
How many tracks is that now, Mike?
10.
And what's next?
Guitar.
Are you going to play that all the way through?
No, just the last couple of verses, when we were all playing tambourines and stuff.
Right,
OK. Right, here we go.
After the electric guitar, Mike recorded a couple more tracks on a synthesizer, which left just one thing missing, the opening drum roll to our tune.
So I'd like you to... I hear you're a drummer.
Well, I always wanted to be a rock drummer when I was at school, you know,
well, this
so
is
it
the,
could be
this
my
is,
big moment.
This is your big moment, OK? You have to put these on.
Sure, I can manage a roll.
Here we go. You have to put them on. And right. I will cue you. As soon as you see my stick come
right.
down, you start your roll, all right?
OK.
Ready? Carry on.
Longer.
Yeah.
Longer.
Start it softer and...
And build up, right.
Yeah, okay. Ready? Here we go.
Well, with everything recorded now, all the various instruments are all on.
Yep.
What's the next step?
Well, at the moment, they're all on a 24-track recorder. Every single instrument is on a different track on the tape recorder, and we have to mix them all up together in the right proportions, like the right amount of barons, the right amount of synthesizers, guitars and everything, and then record that onto thin tape so that whenever anybody plays it, it's always the same. And to do that, I have a computer which helps me do that.
Mike's a perfectionist. Every track had to be played back at precisely the level he wanted. He kept playing the tape over and over again, making minute adjustments. It took around an hour before he was happy.
So here is the world premiere of Mike Oldfield's Blue Peter signature tune.
Right. Simon. That reminds me a bit of Amazing Grace.
He's a remarkable man. He really is a genius.
Yeah.
We've just heard, in fact, that Mike's latest composition, and that's called Incantations, was that has gone, as they say, platinum, which means it's taken over £1 million in the shops, which is quite amazing.
It really is.
And then we'll be back on Monday. We'll be having celebrations. Jack and Jill's third birthday. And just before we go, I have got a message for viewers in Hexham and Ackworth, and that is David Scott will be with us next month. And we'll see you on Monday. Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Bye.